Hey, TreeStuff gang, here in sunny Hawaii, and we're looking at some really big trees that just nerds out for me. What we're looking at is a really old tree, probably entering retrenchment, but look at all the sprouts. Almost the entire tree is nothing but water sprouts, which leaves a good lesson for us that we don't want to remove sprouts because remember, a tree will never grow anything it doesn't need. And it needed to reiterate itself and build more photosynthetic area. So we got sprouts, so they can be safely maintained. So once you see sprouts, don't necessarily think bad, sprouts are good. So with storm mitigation, oftentimes, my guess is this probably suffered from some storm damage and took a lot of its crown away. So as I said, a tree won't grow anything it doesn't need, but it'll respond with a lot of sprouts. So the rule is what we call the rule of thirds when it comes to storm response pruning. So you wanna keep a third, remove a third, subordinate a third. So you're managing kind of the amount there, but also the health and safety of them as well. When you're subordinating a branch, what we're talking about is bringing down the size a little bit so it's a little more stable, as opposed to that long whippy thing, which we're so nervous about, especially during wind loading events. But if you're subordinating, then you're making it a little stronger, improving the taper, and improving the health of that branch. When I look at sprouts to determine if they're safe, which that's our biggest concern is the risk that it presents, I'll go right to where it attaches on the tree and look to see if it's a strong attachment. If it's somewhat weak or cannot support that lever arm or the length of that branch, I'll reduce it or subordinate it so that it's got less load on that attachment. It's all about branch attachments, everything when it comes to the safety of that sprout.